The internet is great. I know that, you know that. I mean, you're using it right now. But why should we have all the fun? Your microbit wants a piece of the action. It wants to get online too. I'm talking about the Internet of Things. Now, I don't mean your microbit is gonna start watching funny videos of capacitors or buying itself batteries off of Amazon. I'm talking about your microbit collecting information and then putting that information on the internet so that you can access it anywhere. But why is that a good thing? Well, what if you wanna know how much light falls on a patch of your garden so you can tell whether your new plant's gonna do well or not? You don't wanna stand out there all day with a clipboard taking values. Or maybe you're curious about the temperature of your room when you're out. Does it get too cold for your pet budgie? All these questions can be answered by logging data to the internet. But doing that can be tricky. One option is to connect your microbit to the computer and then write some code that sends the data over serial to another program that puts it on the internet, but then you have to keep your laptop on all the time. Basically, it's tricky, but Seluxit have sent me a present that should make things a little bit simpler. It's called the Wappsto bit, and in theory, I just slot my microbit in and it's gonna take care of the whole internet part, which is pretty cool. So let's have a go together. I've come up with a simple and fun project to test it out, but you're gonna have to keep watching to find out what it is. So here it is. This is super exciting. Let's take a look. Okay, so Seluxit have told me that this isn't the final design of the packaging, because this is a brand new thing that they're launching. But I really like it anyway. It's fun and colorful and I'm into it. But let's take a look inside. Okay, we'll put this box on the floor. Oh, wow. It's chunkier than I imagined. Let's take it out of this anti-static wrapper. Now we've unwrapped it, let's take a closer look at some of the different parts. We have here, it says microbit connector. So that is where your microbit is going to slot in. And you probably can't see, but inside here, there's a bunch of little metal connectors that touch each one of these gold slivers on the bottom of the microbit. Now remember, those are your pins where you can connect different sensors and other things that you want to use with your microbit. And the connections that this makes with each of those pins travel down here to this row of pointy bits. And they're all labeled, which I really like. It makes it really easy to know exactly what you're connecting where. And I can see we've also got some of the big gold pads at the bottom. So if you want to use crocodile clips like you can when the microbit isn't in this connector, you can still do that as well, which is really good. They've included a reset button here, which is handy because then you don't have to flip the microbit over to get at the reset button. But I like that they've made the shape of the board here. It's got a dip in it so that you can still use the reset button that's on the back of the actual microbit board as well. That's thoughtful. I like that. It looks good so far. Looking at the start guide on the Seluxit website, I think the next thing that I need to do is download the Wappsto app, make an account, and then I'll be able to pair my device with my Wappsto account. So let's have a go at that.
Okay. So let's create an account. I have read the terms and conditions. And then I'm not going to show you my password. Ugh, email confirmation. Okay. Great, that's all confirmed.
Now I've made an account, the next thing to do is connect my Wappsto bit to power via this USB port here. Try doing it the right way up first. Okay, good sign, the LED has come on straight away.
And now I can add it to my account in the app. So I want to add and configure Wi-Fi. Perfect. That top one there is my Wappsto bit. The second one is my TV because my TV is called Hank. Okay, it's doing its thing. Okay, I'm not gonna show you all of the Wi-Fi networks in my area, but I'm gonna choose mine. Now I'm gonna have to run away and find the password for my Wi-Fi because I can't remember it. Your device is set up and added to your list, fantastic.
So that's it, my Wappsto bit is connected to my Wappsto account. So all I need to do now is write some code for my microbit, then slot it in, and I'll be able to log data to the internet, which is really cool. So let's do that next bit. To write some code for the microbit, as usual, we are going to head to makecode.microbit.org and start a new project. I'm gonna call mine Wappsto. And there are some extra ready-made blocks that can help you send data to Wappsto. And to get at those, we're gonna go to advanced, and then down here to extensions, and then we are gonna search for Wappsto. There it is. And now you can see this whole extra menu of blocks has appeared. Now, before we write a program to send data, let's have a think about what data it is we want to send. I just want to do a quick and simple project to begin with to test everything out. So I don't want to use any external sensors or anything fancy, but the microbit's got lots of stuff built in. So I can still do an interesting project just using what it's got on board. My idea is to use the accelerometer data. Now, if you remember, the accelerometer is the part that tells whether the microbit is moving or not. So I'll log the accelerometer data, and then I'm going to attach my microbit to a door, so I'll be able to tell when anyone enters or leaves. That way, if someone decides to come into my room and borrow something without asking when I'm out, I will be able to see the accelerometer data change in the Wappsto app or on the Wappsto website. So let's take a look at the code. To start, we're going to give our microbit a name. This is how it's going to appear on the Wappsto app. So I'm going to call mine door sensor. Next, as part of this onStart block, we want to tell Wappsto what kind of data we're going to be sending, so it's prepared. So we're going to use one of these setup blocks. And I'm going to call the value Excel for acceleration. This value part here looks complicated, but it's there because we can send lots of different data to Wappsto at the same time. Think of it a bit like channels on TV or something like that. So we need a way to tell apart the different streams of data that we're sending. Next, to actually send the data, we're going to use one of these send number blocks. And the number we want to send is in input, it's the acceleration. As a final check, I just want to make sure that the value here matches the value there so that I'm sending the right data to the right stream. In our program, that's really easy because we're only sending one thing. But because you can send more than one piece of data to Wappsto at the same time, if you have a more complicated program, that's something that you should definitely check. Now, I'm just going to finish up with a small pause. So now my program will send data once every half a second. So let's put that on our microbit and then stick it on a door. Yes, I meant stick it very literally. Always best to use what you have for a project, and I had tape. So you might be wondering what this thing is. Turns out the Wappsto bit wants 5 volts of power, unlike the 3 volts that the microbit wants. And my cat is trying to eat the lights. Do you want to learn electronics? Turns out the Wappsto bit needs 5 volts of power, unlike the 3 volts that the microbit takes. So this is a USB battery pack to power the Wappsto bit. So now I am gonna play with this door for a bit, and then we can see what kind of data we've gathered. That should do it. The last really cool thing I want to show you is data dashboards. So you can see your data in real time and graphs and all that cool stuff. So head to wappsto.com. We're going to click on dashboard. And then we're going to add a dashboard. We'll go for a blank one. I'm going to call mine door dashboard. Doesn't look like much yet, but that's because we need to add a widget. Go to this plus icon here, add widget, and let's go for a line chart. For now, I'm going to leave all of the other stuff as default. That all looks fine. You remember earlier when we were writing our code, we gave our microbit a name. Well, now you can see that name appearing here. And boom, we've got a graph. The peaks aren't quite as high as I would have hoped, but you can still definitely see when the door was moving versus when it was still. So I'm going to chalk that up as a success.
Yay!
There are so many more things that you could do with this cool piece of kit. Like, if I wanted to know what my cats were up to in the day, maybe I could use a motion sensor or two. Maybe I could track the temperature as well to know if it's warm enough for them, because they are really spoiled. If I was feeling really lazy, I could use a sound sensor or a vibration sensor to know if the dishwasher was on in the other room. Or maybe I could use an air quality sensor to chart the indoor air quality so I knew when to open a window. I've got tons of ideas, and I'm sure you do as well, so let me know in the comments what you'd use it for. And I will see you next time.